Melissa in Minnesota. Welcome back to my channel. Today is October, and I can't believe we're already in October. It's so crazy. I am pretty good about pre-filming, and October, August, September, that just got hectic. Anyone with kids, I'm sure, in school understands with sports and school activities, and life just got hectic. We're also dealing with colds right now, so pardon the way that I look. It was so crazy because here we are in October. We usually get our first snow by the end of October, usually around Halloween. I don't know if you guys can see out the window. I was hoping that I would be able to get a good background. Pretty much all the leaves are off of our trees right now, and it was so crazy. Another reason we get colds is not only are kids back in school and we're running around with sports or whatnot, but the crazy roller coaster ride of weather has hit. This past Saturday, we were actually doing a lot of yard work. My husband took off last week. We had a project that we needed to get done. We have flooding issues. I posted on Instagram a couple pictures of our barn that we have that houses our chickens and our ducks that we have. We have a small homestead with a garden and some animals, and that has been within the last 8 years since we built it. It is settled, and the last winter we had some flooding in it. This past summer we had a really bad storm, and we literally had to shop vac the water out of there. The ducks loved it. They had an indoor pool, but we did not like it because anything that we store in there got wet, hay, things like that, and it just kind of ruined a lot of things. So this past week we were taking care of some yard work. We had to rent a skid steer, and we had to do some different landscaping, kind of pretty much building a moat maybe around the barn, as I'm going to call it, and do some removal and some moving of dirt, and try to do that. So that was a pretty much sun up to sundown project for the whole week. It was so crazy because Saturday was almost 90 degrees here. Sunday, the wind came in, the rain came in, and I think I'm filming this and it's on a Tuesday, and I believe our high today will probably be 40, 45. So we are not in tank tops and shorts. Oh, it is long sleeves. I'm in jeans. I have socks on, which I usually don't wear socks, only when it gets cold. And I'm actually thinking of putting on a sweater or a sweatshirt. So that tells you the difference. It was like a 40 degree difference in temperature. So pardon me if I sound a little raspy because I'm dealing with a little bit of a scratchy throat. But anyway, you guys know that life gets hectic, and especially, like I said, with kids in school and sports. And my son just finished up soccer. Monday was his last day. They had a party. They had an undefeated year, so yay, go Lumberjacks. It was pretty cool, and I'm so proud of him. He did a great job. He is in middle school, and this is really good. The sport is his sport, and he absolutely loves it. So he had a good year. He scored quite a few goals, and there were a couple of close games that were a 2-0 win for the Lumberjacks, and he scored one of the goals, so I'm very proud of him on that. And like I mentioned, he is in middle school, but he plays a lot of the junior varsity, sometimes older kids, because of the school systems that they play. So I'm very proud of him. My younger son decided not to play football this year. I'm not sure what he wants to do. He's thinking of basketball and maybe soccer next season, but he loves to run. So I think that something like that, those are sports where you're just up and down the field or the court all the time. So I think those would be a perfect fit for him. He was a quarterback in football, and it was okay, but at his age, it's kind of hard because the quarterback does take a lot of hits if you don't have a good defensive line. And so, yeah, that kind of didn't agree with him. He didn't like that too much. So maybe a less contact sport would be better for him. So anyway, let's go on with the video that I am filming today. It is a Vitacost haul. We're in October. So again, you guys know that I pretty much post these sometimes twice a month, depending on if I forgot something, and I will have another order coming. So I will probably post a small little haul later on this month because I am out of flour and I need to buy some. When I went to place this order, they were out of the namaste flour that I highly recommend, and it is my go-to flour of choice. So that will be coming, and of course I will probably add a couple more things to that order, and I'll let you guys know. Hopefully a new couple things. I want to try some new gluten-free items, and I'll let you guys know how I like those and what I get, and you guys will see that when I post that video. But let's go ahead and get started. Multiples in these things, I will just kind of, I'll pull out one, but I won't pull out most of them. I do have them in, since I'm in a different filming location, I don't have them up on a table. They're on the floor, so I will be reaching down. But a staple in our household, and I think that it's helped keep the cold from getting worse. So like I said, I have a little bit of scratchy throat, but I don't think it's going to develop into anything else, and which is a miracle considering, like I said, with the roller coaster ride of the weather we're having. But the Bragg's Organic Apple Cider Vinegar, I recommend this. It is great for building the immune system. I drink a little bit of this in water every morning. You can also make what is called an immunity shot, where you will, it's just in a small little, a very concentrated amount, you will mix some of this with some honey and a little bit of water, and that is, like I said, your immunity shot. You take one of those in the morning or when you're feeling kind of, you know, run down, which I have been, and I've done a couple of those this week, the weekend and yesterday. But I highly recommend this for so many things. It works great as a toner. If you have sunburn, which I try not to get, because we all know that sunburn leads to other things like cancer later on or suspicious moles, things like that. You just don't want to take that chance. But this is really great if you do have a sunburn. It's good for also anything that you would need for cooking, salad dressings, whatnot. Just a very great thing to have in your kitchen pantry. But I picked up four of these, and I'll just put the one down. This is how they come wrapped, and I love this, that they are, there's paper in here, then there's almost what I call like a honeycomb paper that's very squishy, and then they put it in a bag in case anything happens. And that is good for now. However, oops, I'm gonna put that down because it's kind of tippy. I have to stock up now. I can order maybe a couple more of these this following week, but that is it. Once it becomes cold here in Minnesota, they will not, not that Vitacost won't ship, but I won't order anymore because they will freeze and the bottles will crack, and I've never had any luck. I've learned that it just gets too cold here in Minnesota for liquids like that to ship to me. So I stock up during the warmer months, and then I have them all stocked for the season that I need them. So I picked up four of those. I went ahead and picked up another, this is my go-to honey of choice. This is the YS Echo Bee Farms 100% certified organic honey. I buy this now in the 2 pounds. They do have a smaller jar that's probably maybe a little bigger than this size, but I go ahead and buy the 2 pounds. I love this for anything, sweetening teas, baking, spreading on bread, muffins. It's just a great honey. I like it because it is unpasteurized, or I think it's unpasteurized, but it is a raw, yes, unpasteurized, fresh, raw state, unfiltered. It is pretty much as fresh as you can get from the bees. And this is farmed in, I believe it's like the, it's a bioecosystem, the Last Frontier Wilderness, which was over, I believe, in, was it Brazil? Or I can't remember when I did the, anyway, it is not going to be, definitely not local, but there, it's like a wildflower honey, so absolutely love that. The other honey that I've got, again, by the YS Echo Bee Farms, this is the Tupelo honey. This is the premium Tupelo blossom honey. This, is, again, is a raw honey, but I believe this has been filtered because it is not in a solid form like this. Now, in the warmer months, this will become a little softer, but it will never be, and I'm going to say runny, a fine consistency like this. But I like this for anything that I want to spread things on and not have something as firm. And this is just a sweeter honey, I think, and really like this. And I use that more for teas and such. I want to try a different honey, and so when I picked up this order, Vitacost was running a lot of the buy one, get one half off, or they were having a lower price on their brand. So I picked up the Vitacost. This is a US grade A certified organic raw and unfiltered honey. And this is a darker honey. And so I want to try, and because I liked different consistencies, different textures, different taste. And so I have not tried this yet, but I will let you guys know if you're interested. And this was in a 32 ounces. Again, it's 2 pounds. 2 pound honey. And let me see if they have, just so you guys, that was for 2 pounds, that was $7.68, so you guys know. In case you want to know any prices, please let me know and I'll be able to help you with that. And you can also go to the website. But the honey that I usually have, and I've ordered, I don't know how many different jars of this. This usually runs this is $12.19, and that's usually around the price that it runs for. So, but again, I love that. And also, I don't know if you guys know, but honey is a great cleanser for your skin. It has antibacterial properties, so you can also use it for that as well. So that was it in that box. I have 3 boxes, by the way, so I'll try to speed this up a little bit. Something that I have previously ordered before and picked up another one. This is the Vitacost Certified Organic Cacao Powder. I like this. I make my own chocolate sauces and my own hot cocoa, things like that. Anything that needs chocolate, this would be my go-to cocoa powder for that. Also for baking, wonderful. I did pick up these, and I'm going to not put a warning, but I'm going to put a disclaimer here that I should have been more careful when I ordered these, and I don't think I'll have a problem with them, but it's something that I am a little weary of, and I will hesitate to buy these later on or just be very cautious. You wouldn't think that these would have any issue as far as maybe having gluten in them, but I picked up, since they were buy one, get one half off, this is the organic sunflower seed hulled and raw. I wanted these for salads and also for making trail mixes. But the thing that I noted is it says manufactured in a plant that also processes peanuts, tree nuts, soy, wheat, which they have in quotes gluten, and milk products. So I want to put that as a heads up. I'm going to try these, and that's usually my son will take these to school, and so they won't be in the house, but I want to make you guys aware of that. I did not notice that. Going forward, I will look for a product that does not have that. When I was shopping, it was more of a sale. I really wanted sunflower seeds that were already shelled and something I could use for, like I said, trail mixes and salads. And that was not something that I checked on, and I should have, because you usually think sunflower seeds, no gluten. But because of where they're processed, I just want to give you a heads up on that. Same thing with the next item that I picked up. Again, these are the organic cashews, raw. They have the same disclaimer that they were manufactured in a plant with wheat. Going forward, I will look for one that does not have that particular issue. And so, yeah, I want to make you guys aware of that. But these are the Vitacost organic cashews. Again, they are raw, and they are, I believe they are unsalted, if I'm not mistaken. But, yeah, I just don't like to have a lot of salt in things, so I did pick these up. Again, a buy one, get one half off deal. Oh, same thing with the cacao powder. I got 2 of those, so there was a buy one, get one half off. For the trail mix that I just kind of mentioned, some things that I picked up, sorry, getting a scratchy throat there, been talking a lot. So again, I mentioned the trail mix, some other items that I picked up for making that specific recipe. Not a specific recipe, but just to add into. These are no gluten, no nuts. These are made in nature. They're organic. No sugar added. These are the tree-ripened plums, pitted, dried, and unsulfured, non-GMO verified product. I picked these up. And also, again, by made in nature, these are the chewy, delectable slices. They're bananas, organic dried fruit, and again, no sugar added. So I can add these to trail mix. Now I will say that in this order, I had placed one of the products that I got was the Yogi Honey Lavender Stress Relief Tea. This helps calm and ease tension, and it's made with organic lavender flower. I had this in my order. They left it out, but they did send it. The item was missing and I requested it to be sent, so they have an online kind of an issue form that you can fill out, and then they get on that right away, and they did, and I got it within a couple days. So I really love their customer service. They're great on that. So be sure that if there's anything missing, go online, or you could call them. That's not an issue, but I just went online. I checked that that item was missing, and I got a confirmation email, and it was on its way. So no biggie. You guys know that I love the Desert Essence, the tea tree and neem toothpaste. I wanted to try something else, and I had seen some reviews. Was it in a health magazine or one of my gluten-free magazines about the Xyla White? This is a Now Solutions, and I picked up the Now brand. Now Foods, I think, is the same brand for the coconut oil, but this is the refreshment toothpaste. And so I picked up two of these. I just wanted to try a different toothpaste. This is fluoride-free, which we go that way in our house. I just, my father did a lot of research when my grandmother came, she has Alzheimer's. And so my father was doing a lot of research of how fluoride may be traced to that. And since that already runs in our family, I'm trying to avoid anything that may trigger. So this is fluoride-free, SLS-free, gluten-free, paraben-free, reduces plaque, whitens, which the Desert Essence, I don't think, claims to do that. So I wanted something, since I drink a lot of tea, that would help with that. And it is a fresh taste. Again, this is in the Refresh Mint toothpaste. I have smelled this, have not tried this yet, but it smells very close, and it looks very close to your toothpaste that you find on the shelves in your grocer, which the Desert Essence does, but it's with the neem and the tea tree, it's a different flavor. So I wanted to give this a try, and I'll let you guys know what I think on that when I actually, I want to see if there's any difference with the whitening. So another food-related item, I wanted a natural laundry detergent. I do use Tide right now, and that doesn't seem to have any triggers for any of the gluten, but I have an AG washer, and I wanted to try something that maybe would help remove stains. And this is by the company Planet, and it is ultra-powered laundry detergent, free and clear, which means no chemicals or fragrances, dyes, anything like that. Certified biodegradable for HE and standard washers, not tested on animals and hypoallergenic. So I'm going to give this a try. I'll let you guys know how it works on clothes. I have two boys that, like I mentioned, were in sports and they're outside all the time. So we'll see how that works. And moving on to the last box. Most of these are things that I have featured before, so I will let you guys know very quickly how these are. You can check out my past Vitacost videos for more of a review on these, but these have been featured in a past video several times. This is the Simple Bites by Pamela's brand, the gluten-free and non-dairy chocolate chips. If you're looking for something that is like the glutened chocolate chip cookies that are on the shelves, this is very, very close dupe to that, if not a dupe. They're just smaller versus the, like the Chips Ahoy, they're the bigger cookies. But honestly, if you're leading a healthy life, you probably don't need a lot of those anyway, which is my feeling. I don't know. Everybody floats their own boat different, but that's the way I think. And so, yeah, that works just for that little satisfying of the sweet tooth. And then, yeah, then I'm done. I love the Enjoy Life Coco Locos. My store doesn't carry these anymore, so I had to buy these on Vitacost. So I stocked up and got three boxes of those. I love these. They are so close to brownies. And these are just really great. They're dairy-free, nut-free, soy-free, obviously gluten-free, and they are a certified gluten-free product, so I highly recommend these. And they have the, it says now packed with more chocolate chips, which, woohoo, love that, because yeah, we know I love chocolate. A cereal that I mentioned before that I picked up, I Enjoy Life, I love that brand. This is the Crunchy Perky Rice original cereal. It's low fat, low sodium, obviously gluten-free, and it's a certified gluten-free product, no artificial anything. And so, yeah, the ingredients are just, I mean, how simple is this? Rice flour, rice bran, raisin juice concentrate, honey, and salt. Can't beat this. I don't usually eat this like as a bowl of cereal, but I will sprinkle this on like extra granola to add a little bit of crunch, and also into yogurts, and on top of fruit like peaches or pears, things like that. And so, yeah, I really like this. And that was, I picked that up in the grocery store before, but I don't think I've ever mentioned that in one of my videos, or maybe I did buy $1 a way back, but really like the Enjoy Life. Highly recommend that brand. I've actually had, I believe there were three bags. Yeah, there were three bags of these at one time. I believe my sons have already gotten into one. But I picked up, again, the Enjoy Life. These are the semi-sweet mini chocolate chips. These are in numerous Vitacost videos. You guys can go back and check those out for better reviews. But obviously, you know I love Enjoy Life. I picked up one bag of the Mega Chunks. These are great in trail mixes, things like that. Again, I don't find these are good in, well, they're good in baking, but I make banana bread, and it gets kind of hard to slice when you have really chunky chocolate in it. But these would be really good if you were making chocolate chip cookies. So highly recommend that. Enjoy Life is excellent for chocolate chips. Let's see, it looks like I picked up another of the raw whole cashews. Oh, these are, that's right, I got the two from Vitacost, and then these are the Now Real Foods, the whole raw cashews, unsalted. These are definitely gluten-free. They have not been processed in a facility that I'm aware of anywhere on the packaging, so these would be what I would go would purchase moving forward, things that are not a risk of cross-contamination for me. So, but again, heads up on those last products just so you know. Another Enjoy Life product are the soft-baked gingerbread spice. I feature these in one of the past Vitacost hauls that I just did. I highly recommend these. These are great for fall, and I'm not really the pumpkin spice type of girl, but I love gingerbread spice, and these were a hit in my household, so I bought another one of those. The same with the other ones that I featured in a past Vitacost haul, the soft bake. These are the double chocolate brownie cookies. Big hit in my family. So yeah, those were repurchased. The herbal tea sampler, Celestial Seasoning. My store was sold out of these at the time and I really wanted them. This has chamomile, has lemon zinger, has peppermint, honey vanilla chamomile, and sleepy time. So it contains five flavors. There are 18 tea bags in here. I love Celestial Seasoning. It's a great gluten-free tea. Heads up though, they come out with seasonal flavors, and I believe, is it sugar cookie that's out? That's not a gluten-free one, so be sure to read that label. There is on the side, there should be, is it now on the bottom? I can't remember where it is. But somewhere on it, there will be like a little star that will say gluten-free. So be sure, heads up on that, to check those out, especially with those seasonal flavors. Let's see, baking season's coming up. So I picked up, you guys know that Simply Organics is another brand that I trust in my pantry. This is the Madagascar Pure Vanilla Extract. Picked up the big bottle of this because baking season is here. This is 8 fluid ounces. And I will mention, all these glass things were wrapped in paper and tissue and then also in plastic bags, but I have removed those for now. All except for the apple cider, which I wanted you guys to see, but all the glass products are done. I picked up another Simply Organics. This is the onion powder, garlic powder, some oregano, some chili powder, because chili season is here. And also, I like, instead of a lot of my recipes that call for cinnamon, I kind of bump that up a level, and I love cardamom. This is more on the expensive side, but it is a richer taste, and you can also use, if you like chai teas, this is great if you want to make your own chai teas. The cardamom in it, like I said, is just a more richer flavor. It's great for sprinkling in hot cocoa. So that is it for my video. I hope that you guys saw some new products that you may be interested in trying. Remember, a heads up on some of those products. If you're mildly sensitive to gluten, those may not be an issue for you. But if you're like me and you're really sensitive, like I said, that is kind of a warning for next time. And I'll be a little more cautious in that. And it just kind of was something that I just bypassed this time. But I wanted to make sure you guys, as I was mentioning the products, were aware of that. And so, yeah, that is it. I hope everyone is having a wonderful fall and a great day, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, guys.